The trends of food and wine have changed. It was almost going back to the days of Charlie Brown's, when you had the South Australian Hotel and they didn't have anything around the place in Adelaide at all. We opened up Charlie Brown's, okay, and that was the beginning of the, you know, fast food coming in and out very quickly, cheap glass of wine, slice of whatever it might be, or lasagna or spaghetti. And on the opening night, not invited, but Len Evans came in. And he at the time was the one who was promoting wine in the best way he ever could. But then we come back next morning to tidy things up a bit. It was a very late night, of course. On the ceiling was, Len Evans has been here. So that was a fun day. Would have been 1971. It was just cheap food, a good quick glass of wine. And then Jimmy Watson started, so where the trend has been. And of course, in the last 10 years, the cafe scene's come on. The restaurant people come in for a quiet lunch. Two people, four people, maybe eight. But the cafe is one that moves in and out very, very quickly. You know, people in offices want to get in and out very quickly. So we've done that. I mean, you've got to remember where food and wine's gone in the last 20 years. It's changed dramatically. Silver service is going out the door. And of course, it's a tragedy with reference to Chong Lu no longer being involved. And also the fact that McGill Estate also has gone down. The Adelaide City Council had a meeting and they decided to turn Coromandel Place, French Street and Chesser Street into a pedestrian street. Now, that in itself is should have happened 20 years ago. I can put tables and chairs outside under the vines. Now, what better do you need to have a cup of coffee, glass of champagne, glass of red out under the vines in Chesser Street? And that gives it a lovely European feel that this area can really do. And that's pretty exciting sort of stuff. Oh, you mean called a Hall of Fame? Yes. I was privileged to have that. Yeah. Also, my brother also was involved in the business as well. So I can't exclude him. Yeah, he was very much part of the Ragonis come Grimaldi. So we've both been part of it. 75. And let me tell you, Beppe Polesi from Sydney is 86 and he's still in the business and it's a great credit to him. You've got to be happy in doing what you do. Now, I'll leave it at that. Glass of red, or two glasses of red at the most per day, that's it. And it does help your blood pressure.